And welcome, Velocipedians, to something a little bit different. Now, the other day I was sorting out my Flickr account, and I thought, wouldn't it be a good idea to have a slideshow? You've seen some of my current bikes in the walk around videos, so why not put together a slideshow of all the bikes, or most of the bikes, that I've owned? As I passed the 10,000 plus photos mark, I realised that such an idea was going to result in something very, very long, very, very boring. I would probably lose control of it quicker than Boris Johnson over a pandemic. So what I'm going to do is divide it up into categories instead. I'll show you some rallies and some Dutch bikes and some vintage bikes. The first one I'm going to do, because it's what sprung to mind, is the various carrier bikes and cargo bikes that I've had in my time. Be it the traditional British style of tradesman's bicycle or butcher's bikes, as they're known, and a couple of the heavier duty things, the trikes and the continental ones, and a couple of prototypes that I've tried. I haven't got a cargo bike at the moment on the road. I've got a couple which are packed away in boxes waiting to be done, and that's what I need to get round to doing. So anyway, without further ado, here's some of my history with cargo bikes. When I first got back into bikes in the 1990s, it was through Encyclopedia and Bike Culture Quarterly. And that really plunged me straight away into the lunatic fringe of cycling, if you like. It was my close affinity and association with Amsterdam that maybe sit up and take notice of their cycling culture, and particularly the culture of cargo bikes. The more I saw, the more I studied, I realised this was cycling for me. This was my niche in cycling. It's where I feel comfortable. It seems to be where my cycling tribe abide. So that was it. That was cycling for me. So when I moved to York and really plunged back into cycling, the first thing that I got involved with was a cooperative of people with a parcel delivery service, and I spent 6 days a week, really full time, trugging loads of parcels up to 350 kilos around York on these massive things and various other cargo bikes. And boy, was I fit then. I've never been one for stamina, but I got really strong when I was doing this for a living. One bike that I took home from that job was this, a Kemper Philibus, made by Michael Kemper in Germany. He now makes beautiful replica Pedersen cycles, and still makes these Philibus and one called the Lorry. I'd highly recommend it. This fondness for cargo bikes blended nicely into my love of vintage machines. And this was the first thing that I picked up from a friend. It was Philips. And I didn't really restore it, I just knocked about on it like a beta bike, as they say, and I sold it on to another friend, inevitably, like my bikes usually do. But that was it. I had a real liking for these tradesman's bikes, the old traditional British style. I don't really get into these bikes for very long before a Pashley comes into view, and this was the first Pashley that I got. Again, it wasn't restored, it was just run around as a beta and a pub bike and thoroughly enjoyed. But then things get interesting. I was on a job at the university one day, and I came across this old yellow Pashley delivery bike covered in dust with flat tyres in the corner of a bike shed. And the story behind it was it had been purchased by the university for the campus security staff to knock about on. They had almost immediately lost the key, and so the bike lay abandoned with 0 miles on it. I subsequently negotiated its purchase for a very small sum of money, and it was used as a company bike for the bike recycling scheme that I'd founded, the bike rescue project. And then I brought it home with me when I left that. And it started life, as you can see, in the industrial yellow, which was one of the Pashley colours for their industrial bikes. This was known as an RH3 and badged as a courier, and it's the civilian version of the postie bike, and it was used primarily as an industrial machine for large sites and factories and such like. I was working down in London by that time and living on the boat at Canary Wharf, and the bike quickly found favour as a London bike, not only for myself but Raven. She found it a joy to ride and adopted it as her London transport. And it was a superb city bike for knocking about London. I used to ride my big red Cronan, which we'll see later, but Raven really adopted this one, resulting in this one of my favourite cycling photographs, upon which we shall dwell no longer. Sadly, actually in the maritime climate, quickly starts to dissolve, and after a couple of years, this one really needed a rebuild. And the bottom plate where the kickstand mounts fell off through rust. So I was also unhappy with the cheap components on it. So it was time for an upgrade. And upgrade certainly did. Everything was replaced. Alloy rims, alloy hubs. I fitted the new style of Sturmey Archer hubs with a drum brake and dynamo in the front and drum brake and three-speed in the back. Sturmey Archer crank set, alloy handlebars, stem, seat post, the lot. That ready-made basket that you see in there fit perfectly, so that was brilliant. One of the first things I did as well was change the wheel size. For some reason, Pashley had gone over to mountain bike size wheels, presumably for tyre choice. But it meant that it lowered the bottom bracket and allowed the pedals to strike the ground. Raven had chunked a couple of pedals down in London, so I decided to address that and went back to the original 26x1 3/8 wheels for which these frames had been designed, and that brought everything back up to standard. And I upgraded some of the accessories as well. As you can see, the modern Dutch lock on here as well, which the bike's still got now. And a blue colour as well. Keys in nicely with Pashley's modern aesthetic, that and the cream tyres and the honey accessories. So it tones in with things like the Britannia and the Poppy that are made nowadays. And the bike has seen some use as well, perfect for knocking to the shops and picking up a few bits and bobs. And it's done a couple of overnights as well. And it's not just a nice bike as a carrier, and a pleasant ride with the carrier frame on, but it surprised me with another aspect as well. With the carrier frame off the front, it actually makes a really nice little roadster. Very comfortable to ride, and of course robust as well. And I've been on a few little rides with the carrier off. But inevitably, it began to deteriorate again in this climate, and things started dissolving, so it's currently in a box, in the lockup, dismantled, awaiting yet another refurbishment. And I'm deciding whether to completely restore it or just recommission it. In the box next to it, in the lockup, is this one. Another very similar machine. Another one that's been an industrial bike. And coincidentally, underneath the gold hammerite, it's yellow as well. There is an old ICI plant not far from here. It's a saltworks. Not one of their biggest, but it's a big enough plant to warrant having two or three bikes for the staff to run around on. And a local chap who had worked there somehow had this in his shed. How he got it off the site, I don't know. But he gave it to me for free, if I can do anything with it. So it's waiting to be done. And done it will be. In a probably a more traditional style, this one. An interesting thing that it has is the old carrier bike size of tyre, 571, which is 650C or 27x1 and a half. No, 1 3/4. Just to confuse it with mountain bike tyres, the 27 by 175. That's the Myriad 26 inch wheel sizes. So this one's going to be restored back to a very traditional specification, I think. I've done it before, I'll show you another one in a second. This one's also a speed, but I've got a little trick up my sleeve. I'm going to sneak in a coaster brake just to help out the rod brakes a little bit. It's a good thing to do on a single speed bike with rod brakes. It just gives you a bit of reliable weatherproof braking to supplement the rod brakes. Now, just going back in a little bit, I don't know if any of you have seen the TV movie with James Bolam, The Missing Postman. You should really catch up with it. They filmed some of their scenes in North Yorkshire, in Skipton, and at the end of the filming there were a couple of bikes for disposal, which were authentic Royal Mail Pashleys that had never actually gone into service and just been used in the film. A chap in York managed to get a couple of them, and kept one for himself and sold the other one, and I paid 70 quid for it. And here it is. It's single speed, rod brake, but absolutely mint and beautiful to ride. I don't know if James Bolam's actually ridden this one or not. Now, if you were paying attention a few minutes ago, you'll remember this blue bike, an old Pashley with a drop top tube. A friend wanted a all-time themed bike, so it seemed an obvious choice. It got a rebuild. It's not authentic, it never was a wartime bike, but it looks the part. I built the frame to carry the wooden box rather than its original carrier frame, fitted some drum brakes from something old and French, and a nice paint job in camouflage matte. And there it is, a very inauthentic but very cute wartime themed Pashley bike. And from all I know, he's still riding around on it now, taking it to war weekends. I hope he is, anyway. One final Pashley before we move on to red. This was my Pashley Pronto, which is the civilian version of the Mail Star, the final Pashley Royal Mail bike. And I'm delighted to say that these are now available as fully rebuilt from the frame up machines, like a new bike, under the name of Elephant Bikes, and it's a charitable organisation. You buy one, they donate one. So go to elephantbikes.co.uk if you're interested. They really do ride beautifully. This is me moving house along the cycle track on mine, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. And now we come to my piece of resistance in traditional British carrier bikes. This is a very sorry looking specimen that came in, but it's a 1938 Raleigh, so obviously it was worth doing something to. Everything was seized up, everything was in need of complete refurbishment and restoration. So I decided to go mad on it and hit it with my bling ray. And hit it I did. This is a proper burgundy, not the maroon that it looks in the pictures. And there's the end result. Not entirely authentic, with drum brakes and a 3-speed rear hub and a dinky little chain guard from France. But then I've never been one for totally authentic. My bikes are built to my taste for me to ride. And ride it I did. All over the place. I used to go out on a Saturday morning and fetch fruit and veg and eggs from farmers' gates quite regularly. Or just go off for rides in the Fylde. I was still getting the collection of old bikes together at the time. And this was the oldest thing I had at that time. And I became addicted to riding it for a while. A thoroughly enjoyable, properly old, properly authentic vintage 3-speed. Now, anyone with any interest in British carrier bikes will be waiting to see one of these. You see the smaller front wheel. This is the more traditional baker's bike or butcher's bike or grocer's bike. It's what people think of as the traditional British carrier bike. They're more scarce and much more expensive. You can still get them though from Pashley. They're about 1200 quid now, I think, for a new one. So it took me a while to get my hands on one at the kind of price I'm willing to pay. But eventually I did, and I decided to go a little bit mad with it. Mostly because the example I got, an old Raleigh, was very sad and missing its wheels, missing several components. So really ripe for a thorough upgrade. And this is what happened. As you can see, I've gone for my upgrading route again. Not your normal old British butcher's bike. Because it didn't have the wheels, I went for the nearest size, which is BMX front and mountain bike rear. As long as you put chunky enough tyres on, they're just about the right size. And I put Schwal Marathons on, front and rear, which were perfect for everyday use, and the bike was intended for everyday use. So just about everything on it is alloy. The rims, stainless steel spokes, alloy Sachs hubs with drum brake, and things like the handlebars and stem and such like, and levers. All what modern components I had laid around, really. I seem to remember it's an 8-speed Sachs in the back of this one. And the baskets were made by a local basket maker, a blind chap, who just made them to pattern. I gave him the rack frame, and he made the basket to fit. Absolutely wonderful bike to ride. The colour is familiar to sports bike enthusiasts. It's Bianchi Celeste. I had it powder coated because it was going to be a working vehicle, and the honey accents on the saddle and such like just set it off and matched the baskets. It was eventually sold to a sandwich bar who wanted it for their daily deliveries, so as far as I know they've still got it in York. It was a lovely thing, a 1950s or 60s Raleigh. Since I found it, I just thought I'd show you this workshop picture of the bike I'm done. And without the carrier, does that not look like the coolest cruiser you've ever seen? So if you ever find one of these without the front carrier frame, don't discount it. Because you can make something like this and really stand out from the crowd. I think it looks absolutely gorgeous. So now I suppose it's time to talk about the pink thing. The pink thing was a Pashley ice cream trike that was donated to Bike Rescue with the aim of it being turned into a viable working bike. And you can see from this photo, it's got a very short wheelbase, making it very unstable. It pivots in the middle instead of underneath. And it's got caliper brakes acting on steel wheels. The rear brake was okay. It was a Sturmey Archer drum, but it was operated by a long piece of wrought iron which you pushed down from underneath the seat, which meant you took your hands off the steering bar at the front there to perform any braking. It was basically dangerous. So the first thing I did was to stretch the wheelbase by over a foot. I moved the axle to the front of the chassis, and I fitted a steering damper underneath. That immediately made everything a lot more stable, but I still needed to tackle the braking situation. So for that I fitted some proper handlebars and proper brake levers and cables, making it steer a bit more like a proper bike. And here's one of our volunteers out on a mission, probably to the tip, or to rescue some forlorn bike somewhere or other. And it was good as a works runabout, really, as a scrap hauler and around the depot, rescuing dead bikes, because you could get a bike in the front of it. And there it is with a generator in the front. We're probably cutting off a lock up at the university, that looks like, on a dead bike. But mostly it was used for advertising out and about the city. Put it in a different place every day. Take a folding bike in the box and ride back to the depot and leave the bike there. And it became familiar to York people as a bit of a city landmark. So that's the pink thing. On the subject of beautiful but impractical oddities, I did have for a while a couple of Indonesian becaks from Jakarta. Absolutely gorgeous looking things, but very heavy, single speed, fixed gear. Truly awful to ride, but a wonderful icon in what they were. And they attracted a lot of attention on stands and at shows. And the teenage volunteers used to have fun in them as well, so they were worth having for a while. And at least I can say that I've had a bike that has a glove box. On the rickshaw theme, there was also an Indian rickshaw that had originally been in Agra. But this is the only surviving photograph, unfortunately. There was also briefly a Pashley middleweight ice cream trike that was repurposed for use at the cafe at home, but less said about that the better. Although vintage is my thing, one of my best delivery cargo bikes ever is this. It's actually two bikes. It's an xtracycle, which is a rear conversion kit to extend a standard bike into a long wheelbase carrier bike. And you can see the xtracycle is the silver part with the wooden deck which I made, and the bike is the grey part. And it's an unbelievably versatile and robust piece of kit. The bike that I used to attach the xtracycle to was a Marin Point Reyes, a nice quality lightweight hybrid. And it was very versatile. It was the works hack for bike rescue, and it was my daily commuter for a long time. It was my go-to bike for going home, going shopping, whatever. I donated it to bike rescue when I left. I think they sold the xtracycle separately and built the Marin back into a bike, from what I heard. I've certainly never seen it since. But I've no desire to buy one myself. What I'd like to do is make one myself. Which brings us neatly to our final bike today. And this was a prototype that myself and Mike West, who worked for me, knocked together. We were looking at the possibility of building batches of these from the frames that were sent to Bike Rescue, that were donated. And we looked at being able to cut up a couple of frames and weld these together fairly routinely. Unfortunately, it didn't really get any further than this rough prototype, because we realised very quickly the variation, the difference in the type of frames. We rarely got two frames the same, let alone similar. And so it was really a non-starter, in that everyone would have to be designed and built individually, bespoke, and it would just be more expensive than somebody buying a cargo bike. But it was a nice little experiment, and it's something that I would like to maybe do for myself one day. Possibly a tandem adaptation, something like that. It's not just bikes, I've always had a thing for trailers, but really I think that's another video for another day. Thanks for watching this one. I hope you've enjoyed it, hope it's been amusing, and if you have any questions about any of the things you've seen, get in touch with me, either in the comments or by other means, and I'm always happy to chat about cargo bikes and delivery bikes and tradesmen's bikes. I'll do trailers in another video, and the next video I think I'll probably do rallies and maybe Pashleys and some of the lightweights and classic tourers as well. But meanwhile, thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe and share as far as you want. Thank you. Bye-bye.